I go first?
Okay, yeah, you go first.
Sure. Don't let you feel like a bitch.
Rebecca Tiana, I can't believe this day is here. I am unbelievably excited to marry you, and I have been for a long time. I'm excited to marry you today because I am so ready to sleep next to you, to start our life together, and to lead you, protect you, and provide for you. You have become so much to me. You're my best friend, my confidant, my road trip buddy, my co-Disney pin and antique collector, and now soon my wife. I admire and respect you so deeply. Your courage and your strength inspire me to give more of myself every day and inspires me to be persevering. Your sacrificial heart makes me feel really selfish, but this is just one way that you push me to be more like Jesus. Despite trying to be more like him, you push me to be more like him too. I'm so grateful for your influence in my life. I love that you bring out this kind of mature and somewhat responsible, organized, manly provider side of me, and yet I still feel so free to be the completely crazy and messy side of myself too. I love how gentle we are together. I love how missional we can be together. I love how goofy and random we can be together. And I love our handsome baby too. I love you.
Nicholas, I can't believe we made it to this day. Before I met you, I really wasn't sure I would make it to my wedding day because I didn't think I would find my person. But now it's our wedding. You are perfect for me. I love. You understand me and you make me laugh.
Oh my God.
You make me feel important, and when I'm with you, I never feel alone. You don't see my insecurities as burdens. You celebrate them, even when I don't want you to. You are so honest and genuine. That was one of the first things I liked most about you. You aren't afraid to be you or to be broken. You inspire me to love my brokenness and allow the Lord to redeem it. You are so good at bringing your sin and burdens to the Lord and to others. I want to spend the rest of my life bringing things to you and growing closer to Christ together. You love God's people and desire so deeply to serve them and to introduce them to the Father, whom you love deeper than anyone. Something I also admire and desire to learn how to do better from you. Nick, you are so kind. You stop to make people feel seen and to help them in any way you can. Even on the side of the road. I feel so blessed to get to become one with you. Thank you for sacrificing your desires and dreams for my own. Thank you for slowing down with me when I need it and for pushing me forward when all I feel I can do is stand frozen. You remind me that I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. You never let me forget that my emotions do not rule me. Christ does. How did I get so lucky to fall in love with such a godly man?
As Rebecca's eldest brother, I am honored to be a witness to the joining of these two and to celebrate the relationship that, by God's grace, is about to enter into marriage. And let me just say, you two look absolutely amazing. And you made it. All the long nights, conversations, difficult decisions about what color the napkin should be, it's over. God has delivered you both to this moment, and you can be confident that He will continue to carry you forward. So if you know Rebecca, then you know how easygoing she is, but you also know how thoughtful she can be. She's always eager to help and listen if you need someone to talk to. She is just a very genuine person. If you know her, then you may also know that she never gets out of bed before 11 a.m. I've had the joy of watching my little sister grow up into this beautiful, strong, and confident woman of God, and then seeing how God brought this young man into her life. Seeing Rebecca's journey from Eugene, then to Pullman, and now standing here today in front of Nick, has been like a beautiful love story. And I can't wait to see what God has in store for her next. I haven't had many opportunities to get to know Nick, so I asked his parents to write some words of encouragement for him today. From his father, Jay. Nicholas, my prayers these last 6 months have included the hope that you will keep Christ in the center of your marriage. Through his encouragement, your marriage will be a lasting example of his love for both you and Rebecca. Last Christmas, I shared a story with the two of you about how people tend to focus on the endurance of marriage. And if you can just hang in there, everything will be fine. But as I said, I believe that today is the beginning of a long, wonderful love story of your lives together. Full of good times that you can build on and reflect back on as you grow and change together. I believe your story will be a succession of beautiful days as you learn more about each other. Nicholas, I believe God will give you all the wisdom you need to lead your family through the good times and challenging times. And I believe that you have found the perfect partner to share your life with. Nick, you take Rebecca to be your wedded wife, to love her unconditionally, to honor and cherish her, to walk faithfully before the Lord so that you may lead your house and family in truth. From this day forward, as long as you both shall live. And to you, Rebecca, take Nick to be your wedded husband, to love him unconditionally, to care for him as best you can, to walk faithfully before the Lord, to follow and support him, so that you may offer him your love and respect. From this day forward, as long as you both shall live.
Thank you.
I think we're all ready to party with you. As a follower of Jesus and by the authority given to me by the state of Oregon, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Nick, kiss your bride.
Something about you makes me lose my cool. It's dumb, the way you turn me straight into a fool. Ain't fun, girl, you make my heart go like a drum. Ain't never felt this way for anyone. Something about you makes me melt like butter. I try my best to keep calm, push up, but when you look at me, I shatter into pieces, cause I'm happy.
with you.